Welcome. Today we try to learn basic rule of algebra. At first we try to understand rule of addition and subtraction. We start with simple example. 8 plus 7, we easily ask, answer is 15. 24 minus 12, we ask, answer is 12. But sometime different sign create problem. So we try to understand this rule. We try with number line. We know 0 is in center in number line. In number line, upper term is increasing order, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and lower term are decreasing order, minus 1, minus 2, etc. If 2 is on the top in number line, then we can try to write lower term. Lower term is 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, etc. If minus 2 is at the bottom in number line, then we write upper term. Upper term is minus 1, 0, 1, 2, etc. Now we try our rule to understand. Adding means increasing or move upward. Subtracting means reducing or get downwards. At first we take two simple examples. In first example, 3 plus 4, we see in third column 3 is here. We move 4 step upward, 1, 2, 3, 4, we get 7, so the answer is 7. In second example, 3 minus 5, 3 is here, we move 5 step downward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here is 2, so the answer is minus 2. We try some more example. Minus 1 plus 3. In second column, minus 1 is here. We move 3 step upward. 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 2. In fourth example, minus 4, minus 3. Here, minus 4. We move 3 step downward, 1, 2, 3, so we get minus 7, answer is minus 7. Now we try to create rule with above 4 example. We see in first and fourth example, both term are sign same, and we add these both number. So first rule is sum in the same sign. In example second and third, both term are sign different, and we subtract both example. So second rule is subtract in the opposite sign. Third rule is at the end sign of large number. In first example, large number is 4 and its sign is plus, so we put plus 7 answer. In second example, large term is 5, its sign minus, so answer is minus. In third, large term is 3, its sign plus, so answer has plus sign. And fourth example, large term is 4, its sign minus, so answer is minus. We try to understand some more example. First example, we have two term and both term has opposite sign, so we follow second rule. We subtract both term and the answer is 11. Now follow third rule. Large number is 17, so we put minus sign in his answer. In second example, both term sign has opposite sign, so we subtract this both number. We get 16 and large number is 23, so answer is in plus. In third example, both term has same sign, so we follow first rule. We add this both number, answer is 34 and bigger number is 21, so answer is in minus. In fourth example, both term has same sign, so we follow first rule. Addition of two number is 57, bigger sign is 36, so answer is in plus. Now we take some more example. Here two terms are given. At first we see the both term has same variable. If both term has different variable, then addition and subtraction is not possible. Both term variable must be same. Here both term variable are same, so we follow above rule. Here both term sign is different, so we follow second rule. 9x 4x, 9x minus 4x is equal to 5x. We follow third rule. Big term is 9, so answer is in plus. Here two terms variable are equal, so we follow above rule. Both term has different sign, so we subtract both term. Answer is 14yz and bigger term is 23, so answer is in minus. Here variable of both term are same. Both term has same sign, so we follow first rule. 12 plus 6 equal to 18 and variable is xy. Here 12 is bigger term, so answer is in minus. In this example, both term variable are same, so we follow above rule. Both term has different sign, so we subtract it. Answer is 22x square y bigger term is 32, so answer is in minus. In this example, both term variable are different. First term has x square y and second term has x y square. So answer is not possible. This rule is useful in every chapter of algebra. It is not possible to learn algebra without this rule. So practice this rule constantly. If you find this video is useful to learn the basic rule of algebra, please like and subscribe this video. Thank you.